Good morning and welcome to Fort Sellar Elementary School. This is your principal, Mr. Lin, and I hope that you had a wonderful Tuesday yesterday. Today is Wednesday, September 29th, 2021, and we are back to a day one. Now, before we kick off this wonderful day, before we start savoring what is right here and right now, allow yourself permission to let go of the past, to let go of what happened 20 minutes ago, to let go of what happened on Tuesday, right? And also give yourself permission to let go of the future, right? Things that are worrying about us 20 minutes from now, or what's going to happen on Thursday. You see, all that matters is just arriving on Wednesday. Here we are. And let's just use our senses and begin to notice what is around us, okay? Use our eyes for a moment and scan your environment and focus on something that catches your eyes. It might be interesting right off the bat, or maybe it's not. In fact, if you find something that's kind of boring at first, study it until it seems interesting. You know, I'm actually looking at a piece of fuzz right here on the couch. I'm going to look at it. I'm going to study it. I'm going to look at the colors. I'm going to look at the shape. I'm going to study its size. I'm going to determine from my eyes if it might be soft if I picked it up. And then with your nose, take a breath in and slowly let it out. What do you sense with your sense of smell? Right? Because that is one of our five senses. Use your ears now and pause and listen. What do you hear? And then with your skin, what do you feel, right? Whether it's the air brushing against your skin, whether it's your clothing, whether it's my tight collar here, I'm not going to judge it as comfortable or uncomfortable. I'm just going to simply notice that I feel a certain way. That's it. Now today we're going to continue to practice the smelling of the flower and the blowing out of the candle, and I want to invite you to join me. So let's get ourselves settled. I'm sitting on a couch. I know that I can feel how Earth is pulling me down with gravity. I also can feel this couch holding me up. I can actually sense where my body meets the couch and it's holding us up. Okay? Very good. Now, I'm going to close my eyes. You don't have to. Go ahead and take that first breath in through your nose. Smell that flower. Allow the air to come in and fill your belly full of air. And then go ahead and bring that flower down and turn it into a candle and gently blow out with your mouth, making that candle flame dance and flicker. Nice and slowly. In. Fill your belly full of air, and then slowly blow it out, or at least make that flame dance and flicker again. Now, notice how your body feels as you bring that fresh new air in through your nose, up and down into your belly, filling your lungs, filling your belly like a balloon, and then notice where you stop breathing in and begin to blow out. Make that flame flicker and dance. Notice how your shoulders are relaxing. Notice how your back also relaxes. Breathe in again. Fill your belly full of air. And then bring it back down. And as you breathe out, notice how your body just settles into your chair, or in my case, the couch. Breathe in again. And in a moment, you'll hear a bell or a chime. Listen to it as it gets quieter and quieter. Blow out, breathe out. When you can't hear that chime anymore, that's when you can open your eyes very gently and awaken to the world that is around you. Breathe in. Breathe out. Welcome to a new day right here at the Fort, where you are loved, where you are cared for, and where we want you to succeed. Now, whether you have a great day or not, that's ultimately your choice. So choose wisely, work at it, and enjoy the rewards. Always enjoy the rewards. That in itself is a blessing. At this moment, please stand and face the flag for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you for joining me. Go ahead and take a seat. I am so grateful that many of you guys are breathing with me, practicing breathing, giving yourself an opportunity to know the blessings that are going on right here in front of you. Now, before we move on, I want to go over a couple things. Number one, we know our three B's by now, right? We've gone over them every day, and we went over them yesterday in the PBIS assembly. Number one, show that you're respectful towards yourself as well as to others. Do things that make you proud. Even if no one else saw it, are you still doing things that make you proud? Because ultimately, that's what matters. You're the one who's going to be thinking about what you did today at night, right? So do things that make you proud. Proud of yourself. Also show that you're responsible. Responsible in taking care of your hands, your feet. Even the words that are coming out of your mouth. They can be hurtful, but you can choose to be helpful. It's really up to you. Give it a shot. And finally, show that you're ready. We talked about this yesterday. Readiness to learn. It's easier said than done. Learning is hard. Just don't give up. And every time you don't give up, you are showing that readiness. And I love you for that. In the month of October, I know it's still September, but we're about to go into October. I want you to know that we're going to focus on this character trait of self-control. That brings us back to that B of being responsible. Can you control your hands? Can you control your feet? Can you control the words that come out of your mouth? Can you control how loudly or quietly you're talking in the cafeteria? You see, there's a lot of things that we want to do. Sometimes those things that we want to do aren't good ideas. I shared with many of you guys, when I was 5 years old, one of my favorite things to do is jump into puddles. I know my mom didn't want me to do that. And I also know that I was ruining my clothes and my shoes if I did it. And so the day I decided to take off and go into the backyard after a nice hard rain, and I stopped myself before I jumped into that puddle, was also the day I also realized I need to practice self-control, and I did it. And I was so proud of myself. You know, here's the thing. My mom didn't even see me stop myself. But speaking of respect, I did it because it was the right thing to do, and nobody else saw it. But even though I am now 38 years old, I still remember it. And I'm still proud of myself. I stopped myself from doing something I shouldn't do, even though I wanted to do it. I know you all have stories where you have done the same thing, where there's something you want to do, but you stopped yourself and you held back and you showed self-control. I think that's awesome. All right. Now, before I sign off, I also want to share with you, I'm going to pull this up real quick. We have some new leaders in this Race for Education fundraiser. You see, in second grade, we still have Miss Jackson as the leader in second grade. But I just got word that Miss Lucky's class is this close. And don't discount Miss Kane's class. Don't discount Miss Crandall's class or Miss Frederick's class. Don't discount Miss Eshelman's class. You guys are all inching closer. Miss Jackson's still holding the lead in second grade. But look out. And then in first grade, we've got a little bit of a battle at the top because now we have Miss Thomas's class at the top of first grade. Miss Thomas's class is taking the lead, but Miss Booth's class is not far behind. You guys are close. Once again, let's not discount Miss McDonald's class. Let's not discount Miss Ogrechek's class or Miss Hartman's class. You know, there are some really, really, really good fundraisers in each of those classes. Don't give up on those. And then in kindergarten, Miss Yoakum's morning class. Miss Yoakum's morning class is taking the lead in kindergarten. But next door, Miss Zurich's morning class. Really close. Knocking on the door. So keep up the great fundraising. You know this money goes to great work for our PTO as I pay for assemblies and activities and field trips even. Okay. But before, because I do want to let you keep going for the rest of the day, here's what I want you to hear, because I believe everyone should hear it from someone they love or somebody who loves them. And that's this: I like you just the way you are. I love how different you are. I love that you are different and that you are unique. And I love you just the way you are. Have a great Wednesday, everybody.